Another thing that you might want to calculate is somebody's years of service. We're basically going to use the same kind of formula that we used in calculating the age in a different video. So I'm going to say equals today, open parentheses, close parentheses, minus the hire date. Now we're going to format this column as a number rather than as a date. And then I'm going to take away the decimal places. So this means that they had 7,220 days of service. Well, we want that to be years of service. So what you do is, we're going to go up to the formula bar. We're going to surround that with parentheses so that it's going to do the subtraction first, and we're going to divide that by 365. And now that person has 20 years of service. So let's see. They were hired March 29th of 1991. I'm recording this on January 3rd, 2011, so it really would be 20 years of service, as we can see. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that down. And now we can see that we have the years of service, and in another video, we calculated the age. So look at the formula. This is equals to open parentheses today, open parentheses, close parentheses, minus F2. Which is the hire date, close parentheses, divided by 365. So today is a function that represents today's date. We're going to subtract the hire date from today's date. We're going to get the, that'll give us the number of days. We put that in parentheses so it does the subtraction first, then we divide the whole thing by 365, which will give us the number of years. So that's a great calculation, perhaps to calculate the aging or the years of service or something like that.